Yo, what is up guys, back for another video, and today's video is a manga to read, and it is a horror one, or it is a thriller one, and I think this might be the second thriller or the first horror manga that I'm recommending. It's called Another. You can read it on, I think, a Manga Geek, Manga Reader, I'm not sure. Actually, let me check right now. You can read it on, yeah, Manga Geek. If you have, you know, iPhone, Android, I mean, we all do, but you know, that's besides the point. Anyways, this manga reminds me of a lot of, okay, let me just start off with this. I'm not a manga, like, horror, I'm not a scary person in general, so I like to, you know, broaden my, I guess, views on reading manga, horror manga in general. So I thought I'd try this one out. The cover looked decent. It looked interesting. I think that's a better word for it. Anyways, this is about a kid who goes to a school, and this classroom, it's like, I swear they've done an anime like this before, but there was a, so people in this classroom die for uncertain, like, reasons, like, out of the blue. I'm not going to spoil how, when, who, and, you know, all that, just because, you know, it's interesting if you read it to find out. And all the students are, like, they're being all sketch towards this guy who just wants to know what the hell is going on, but no one's telling him anything. And he makes friends with this girl who looks like Toka with an eye patch, and, well, no one can see her, or everybody is ignoring her, I don't know. And all of a sudden they can't see the kid, or they can't see the guy either, because he associated himself with her. But, like, are they ignoring him? I don't know. That's the mysterious part. Like, what's this girl's backstory? The whole eerie vibe you get from this manga, it's just, it's creepy, you know, especially if you read it at night, if you're one of those, like, night readers, because, you know, I'm nocturnal. I don't sleep at night at all, so I'm sitting there reading manga, homework, you know, just stuff like that in general. But as you read this at night especially, and as you, like, read it, you dive into the world, and it's like, it's very, very, like, intriguing. You want to know what's going to happen next. I usually don't encounter that with, like, horror mangas in general. I just wait for, like, the cliche, like, scary part, you know what I mean? But this one builds up to it. It's like these certain things that are happening right now make no sense, but, like, as you read, like, five, maybe six chapters later, you're like, oh, I get what it means. I get what the whole, like, aspect of what they did that chapter. So it's good to keep reading. You figure out stuff as it goes on. That's why I said it's like a thriller. It's like a horror. You get, like, you definitely get a mysterious vibe, just because, like, the girl in general, the classmates, even the teachers too. So, like, there's something wrong with this school. And it's like, I kind of want to know what it is. Like, you meet these new characters as you keep reading, and they're edgy, they're weird. Like, you definitely see their panels drawn, but you don't get their character development or an introduction to them as you read, because more and more people are trying to make this kid not learn the truth about the school. Because I guess bad things happen. I'm not gonna spoil anything, but definitely worth the read. I highly recommend this one. If you're not, like, a horror manga reader like me, or just, like, a scary, or, like, I definitely would say this is slow. This is definitely not fast-paced manga like my other recommendations. This one, you have to actually invest. You have to read it. You have to understand, like, you just have to understand that it's gonna be slow. And it pays off. It really does. So don't give up on it by, like, chapter 15 or, like, 17, and you're like, oh, we're not getting anywhere. You definitely will get somewhere as you read on. That's what I'm saying. You have to, like, invest in it. And I'm not saying to, like, wait for the point to where it hits and then you're like, oh, it's actually good now. No. You definitely get some content as you build up to the big, like, reveals. You know, so, like, definitely read it, like, learn the characters. It's great. It's really, really good. Don't skip over. Don't sleep on it. Another is definitely good. I definitely think if this had a couple more chapters, or, like, an arc, a solid, like just like a solid arc, or, like, not just like a solid, like, yeah, I guess you could say arc, it would be anime. It would definitely be a good anime for sure. Like the eerie vibe you get from it, like the awkward silence, like, you know how in like a manga you don't get to make that silence, it's just like you just go to the next panel, but with this one you get that silence. It's weird. It like inserts itself. It's like super awkward. Like, I'm not trying to make it like a silence, but it just ends up being one. Like, once the character said something, like, oh, and the panels are drawn beautifully. Like, when this guy asks a question about like something he's not supposed to ask, like the panels of these characters, that like, they're great. It's so dark, it's eerie, you know, it's like some horror shit, you know. Anyway, let me know what you guys think about this manga. Let me know when you guys read it, and let me know what you guys think about it once you've read it. And overall, just let me know what you guys think about horror manga in general. This is like my third, might be my third one I've read. Just because I don't really dive into horror mangas that much, just because I think they're like cliche. But I definitely made a good choice diving into this one. But let me know what you guys think about it. And yeah, deuces.